Michele and Kyle Hosking can enjoy an afternoon stroll at Italian Lake. No worries on this day. That wasn't the case a year ago.
I thought I noticed a bump, but didn't think much of it. And I was sitting on the floor, actually, at one point, and my mother-in-law was kind of sitting a little bit higher and noticed that I had a little bit of a bump on my neck.
She said, "Have you checked yourself lately?" And my wife said, "No." And she's like, "The more I think about it, I think I did feel something." And my mom was like, "You should probably get checked out." And within a few days, you know, we'd started the whole process.
So went to the doctor, did lab work, because of course, you know, you want to make sure there's not a thyroid issue going on. So they did blood work. And on top of that, she kind of pre-ordered an ultrasound to check, because there was definitely you could feel a large nodule there.
The findings on the ultrasound prompted doctors to order a biopsy.
And the results came back as suspicious for papillary thyroid cancer. But with that result, that has about a 60 to 80% risk of thyroid malignancy or thyroid cancer. And so she came to me to seek basically a surgical opinion, because we do recommend that we remove at least half the thyroid or the entire thyroid.
You get a little nervous, you hear cancer, and you just get nervous regardless. Of course, you do online research and you try to look, there's a lot of information. So I think talking to Dr. Boltz was very helpful.
Dr. Boltz talked to Michele about a test that would help her decide what to do.
We have another study that we can do called ThyroSeq, and that's a molecular marker study. And it gives us an idea based on patients' genes if they will have a higher risk of having thyroid cancer.
We got the results of ThyroSeq back saying that it was 99.9% chance it's going to be positive for the cancer.
So that kind of swayed her decision into having her entire thyroid taken out.
I just kind of wanted it done and over with, and regardless, good prognosis or not, it's still something in there that shouldn't be. So you just want to get it out and kind of move on.
So surgery was scheduled.
Her surgery went very well. You know, we started on the side where she had the cancer. We removed that portion of the thyroid, and then everything looked fine. I didn't see any grossly abnormal lymph nodes that I would have to take in the middle portion of her neck. So then we went on to remove the other lobe.
She came downstairs, informed me everything went really well, told me that she was coming in, you know, out of the surgery, she was going through recovery, and that it was basically her decision when, you know, I was able to see her and anybody else.
Surgery itself, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be honest with you.
Her final pathology did come back as papillary thyroid cancer within that thyroid nodule, but her pathology overall was very favorable. There were no lymph nodes, and there was no invasion of the cancer outside of the thyroid. So she actually has a very low risk thyroid cancer. And fortunately, she does not need any other therapy going forward other than routine screening.
News that Michele and Kyle were hoping for.
She's doing great. She's not as tired. I think she's got a little bit of relief now too.
I get up every morning, I take my little pill for my thyroid, and that's it. It's relief. It's nice. I feel good that it's done and over with.
We're finally getting back to some sort of normalcy.